In this video, we talk about the integrated circuit manufacturing. We see the basic principle of the process of making a chip. The level of performance of the CPUs or DRAM and the NAND technology is greatly improved over the years, and this is due to the improvement in the integration. We went from integrated circuit to VLSI, very large scale of integrated circuit, and to ULSI, ultra large scale of integrated circuit. But how is manufactured an IC? Semiconductor device fabrication is the process used to manufacture semiconductor devices. Typical integrated circuit chips, such as modern computer processors, microcontrollers, and memory chips, such as NAND flash and DRAM, that are present in everyday electrical and electronic devices. It is a multiple-step sequence of photolithographic and chemical processing steps, during which electronic circuits are gradually created on a wafer made of pure semiconducting material. Silicon is almost always used, but various compound semiconductors are used for specialized applications. Here we see the whole process, and later we focus on some important steps. First, we start with the silicon crystal ingot, which looks like a giant sausage. Then the ingot is finally sliced into wafers, no more than 0.1 inch thick. The wafers go to a series of processing steps, during which patterns of chemical are placed on each wafer, creating transistors, conductors, and insulators. A single microscopic flaw in the wafer in one of the dozen patterning steps can result in that area of wafer failing. These defects make it impossible to manufacture a perfect wafer. The simple way to cope with this imperfection is to place as many independent components as possible on a single wafer. The wafer is chopped into these components called dies, or informally chips. Dicing enables you to discard only those dies with a flow rather than the whole wafer. Then we package the good dies and test them again, discarding the bad ones. And last, we are ready to send them to customers. The entire planet Earth contains approximately 17% of silicon, the third most abundant element after iron and oxygen. But the natural occurrence of pure elemental silicon is irrelevant in terms of volume. For the production of elemental silicon, quartz sand is reduced in melting reduction kilns approximately 2000 degrees Celsius, with a purity of about 98-99%. But this is not enough. The concentration of impurities in the raw silicon is too high by many orders of magnitude for use as a semiconductor in microelectronics. To achieve the required electronic properties, the melted quartz silicon must be refined to hyperpure silicon. For hyperpure silicon, you can use the Czochralski method, in which a cylindrical silicon monocrystal is pulled from a silicon melt. First, polycrystalline silicon, optionally together with dopants, are melted in a quartz crucible at a temperature greater than 1400 degrees. The silicon melt temperature is kept constant roughly above the silicon melting point. A monocrystalline silicon seed crystal with the desired crystal orientation is dipped into the melt and acts as a starting point for the crystal formation, supported by the heat transfer from the melt to the already grown crystal. The seed crystal is slowly, a few centimeters per hour, pulled out of the melt, where the pull speed determines the crystal diameter. All this happens in a special kiln, and this is the final result, the silicon ingot. The silicon ingot is now chopped into slices with a special saw, and this is why the wafers have a circular shape. On these slices, we apply the lithography method. After designing the circuit, we need to implement it on the silicon semiconductor in order to realize the transistors, the capacitors, and the connections. The fabrication of an integrated circuit, or IC, requires a variety of physical and chemical processes performed on a semiconductor substrate. In general, the various processes used to make an IC fall into three categories: field deposition, patterning, and semiconductor doping. Films of both conductor, such as polysilicon, aluminum, and more recently copper, and insulators, various forms of silicon dioxide, are used to connect and isolate a transistor and their components. Selective doping of various regions of silicon allows the conductivity of the silicon to be changed with the application of voltage. By creating structures of these various components, millions of transistors can be built and wired together to form the complex circuitry of a modern microelectronic device. Fundamental to all of these processes is lithography, i.e. the formation of three-dimensional relief images on the substrate for subsequent transfer of the pattern to the substrate. The final result is the patterned wafer. After the creation of a patterned wafer, we use a dicer to free the dies from the wafer. After testing the dies, we package them and retest them, and then they are ready to be sent to customers. This is what foundries as TSMC do for making chips, like Ryzen CPU by AMD. The cutting-edge part is the lithography process, where you use special mask in order to create a transistor with 5 or 3 nanometer gate.
Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put the thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.